Hello everyone, welcome to Coders Camp. Hope you're all doing great. So today we are going to cover Pacific Atlantic water flow. So the input given here is an M cross N matrix and we have to return a list of list which consists of coordinates of the given matrix. So the problem statement says the M cross N matrix of non-negative integers representing the height of each unit cell in a continent. The Pacific Ocean touches the left and top edges of the matrix and the Atlantic Ocean touches the right and bottom edges of the matrix. The water can flow in four directions from a cell to another cell with height equal or lower. So find the list of grid coordinates where the water can flow to both Pacific and Atlantic Ocean. So now let's understand this problem with an example. Here is our given input matrix. The problem statement says the top and left rows of the given matrix are covered by Pacific Ocean. So let's represent that in blue color. And the bottom and rightmost side of the given matrix or continent is covered by Atlantic Ocean. So consider it is represented in green color. Now the question is to find the coordinates where water flow to both the oceans. So now start filling the cells that can be covered by Pacific Oceans in blue color. So as we know, all the cells towards the left side of the matrix or continent and top of the continent are covered with Pacific Oceans. So now from the top cell, which is having the height of cell 1, it can flow the value or water to the down cell. The same way from 2 to 3 the water will flow. Same way from 3 to 4 the water will flow. Also 5 is a common cell between Pacific Ocean and Atlantic Ocean. So the water from 5 can also flow to 4. So now from these cells, let us calculate from where and all our water will flow. That is, the second row is completely filled with blue color. So the same way from 2 it can flow to 4. From 3 it can flow to 5 or from 4 it can flow to 5 because it will flow from all 4 directions. So it cannot flow to 3 because 3 is a lower value than 4 as well as 5. So it cannot, the blue cannot be filled in 3. So now from 4 to 7 it will also fill to 7. Same way 5 is also a common cell which has both the Pacific and Atlantic waters. From 5 it stops because it cannot fill to both 3 as well as 1. The same way from 7 it stops, it cannot fill to both 1 and that is to the right and bottom. So now the cells stopped flowing the Pacific Ocean water. So now let's fill the Atlantic Ocean's water in green color. Starting from the bottom right cell 4, from 4 this is already filled with Atlantic water. So from 2 it can flow to 4. So let's color it with green. The same way from these things are already in green. So now from 4 it cannot flow to any other cell. It stops. But from 5 it can flow to 1. From 1 it can flow to 3. The same way from this one it can flow to 1. Also this one is green. So now let's see what are the cells that are intersecting, which means this 4 cell is intersecting and this cell is already intersecting. The same way from this 4 it can flow to the neighbor cell, the left cell, so this 4. So now this 4 cell is colored with both blue and green. The same way from 3 it can flow to 5. So we'll color 5 also with both blue and green. From 5, no, it cannot flow to 4 as well as 3. So it stops at 5. The same way from 1 it can flow to 7. But from 7 it cannot flow to 6 or 4 because it cannot flow to the lower cells. So now this is another common cell. That's it. Our Atlantic Ocean will not further pass on to the further cells because the other cells' heights are small. So now what are the cells that are intersecting? From here, this cell, this. So now the cells I marked are colored with both blue as well as green because those cells are the cells which can contain both Pacific and Atlantic waters. So these are the coordinates we have to pass as the output. So we clearly know this is something representing like graph or tree. So we can use any traversal technique, either BFS or DFS, to get this done. So in this video, we are going to get the help of BFS to solve this problem. So let's see how are we going to approach this. So here I'm going to maintain two data structures for both Pacific as well as Atlantic. And I'm going to fill the values of each cell with visited or not visited for both Pacific and Atlantic. So what are the possible cells that can fill Pacific water will be recorded in the Pacific array. The same way, what are the possible cells that can have the water of Atlantic will be recorded in this array. Finally, I'm going to compare both this array if the values matches, which means both the cells are intersecting. So those are the coordinates we have to return as the output. So for BFS, I'm going to have two queues, one for Pacific and another for Atlantic. So I'm going to start filling my values of the left and top cells in my Pacific and bottom and right cells in my Atlantic. And I'm going to poll the coordinates of each cell to find whether we can fill the water in its neighboring cell. For example, if I am taking the cell 0,0 for Pacific, I'm going to consider all the neighboring cells left, top, bottom and down and check whichever value is higher. If it is higher, I'm going to put those coordinates into my Pacific and further from that cell, we are going to explore whether we can fill the water in the neighboring cell. If not, if it doesn't satisfy the condition, then we are not going to add that to our queue. The same way, we are going to consider the last cell and add it to the Atlantic. From that cell, I'm going to fill or explore my neighbors and check whether they satisfy that we can fill the water to the neighboring cell. If we can fill, then I'm going to add those coordinates to my queue of Atlantic. And further from that cell, whether we can fill the water to the neighboring cells, that we are going to explore. Same way, whenever we visit the cell of Pacific and Atlantic, I'm going to put true or false to the data structure we have created. Finally, compare both and return the values. So let's see the code now. First, let me initialize an array directions to help us to calculate all four directions from the cell. So first, let's check the basic condition that if the given array is empty, then return an empty array list. So let's calculate the row and column values. So now initialize two queues, one for Pacific and another for Atlantic, and add the values of Pacific and Atlantic cells. So here in our queues, we have added the left and top cell coordinates for Pacific and right and bottom cell coordinates for Atlantic. So now let's declare two arrays for Pacific and Atlantic to explore the cells that can fill the water correspondingly. We'll write the BFS later. So now after calling the BFS function, our Pacific reach and Atlantic reach will be having the coordinates where it can fill the water. So finally, compare both of the arrays and if the value matches, that are the coordinates we are looking for. to finally return the output list common cells. So now let's spend some time on writing the BFS function. So we are going to take the coordinate of each cell from our queue and we are going to put true that we have visited the cell or we have flowed the water to that cell. So now we are going to calculate all four direction coordinates of this particular cell and check whether we can flow the water to those cells. For that we are going to get the help of a direction array which we have initialized earlier. So once we have calculated the coordinate of new cell in any of the direction, whether it is in the limits first and whether we can fill the values or not. So here we are checking whether the newly calculated coordinate exceeds the limit of rows and columns, or if the value is lesser than the previous cell or the parent cell, then we are not going to update anything. Otherwise, if the new cell came across all these conditions, which means we can flow the water to that cell, so add it to our queue. So finally, once we have updated all the visited cells for that particular ocean, return the result array. So once we have got the result from this BFS function for both Pacific and Atlantic, we'll compare the values of both the arrays and finally add the coordinates of whichever cell has the matching value. So now this is done. So let's run. Okay, we missed one more condition, that if we have already visited the node, we are not going to visit it again. So we have to add one more condition, that if the result of then continue, because if we are iterating through the visited node again and again, it is going to time limit exceed. So let's run now, hope it works. So yes, let's submit. Yes, a solution is accepted. So thanks for watching the video. If you like the video, hit like and subscribe. Thank you.